so much of this breakfast and its purpose. It went like this. Life is not about the destination. It is about enjoying the journey. I couldn't help think that our students, now in these troubled times, have to concentrate on the money for their higher education. And I don't have the time to enjoy what an achievement it is. We also are in the same situation. Most of us realize how important college is and how expensive. We want to help, but money is tight. The job market is poor. Many of us are out of a job. This is when we have to make sacrifices, and that is not always easy to do. I know that the job market had not been kind to many of us, but our children deserve a chance.
Said, everyone is capable of greatness because everybody is capable of service. And that is why you're here. That's why we're honoring these very, very special young people who have won the essay contest with writing that I think is absolutely superb in its force and its commitment and its expression and energy. And so I'm honored to be here to honor them, and I have certificates of recognition from the Senate of the United States. Some of you may think the Senate is not doing all that much these days, but on a bipartisan basis, overwhelmingly, we adopted these certificates of recognition, and I want to present one to Rudine in honor of her very, very important service. And Rudine, thank you for all you have done over the years. I'm honored to be your friend.
As many of us remember, the night before he died, he gave a speech at a church, and he gave his famous, "I've been to the mountaintop, and I've saw the promised land." He said, "I may not get there with you, but I saw the promised land." He saw the promise of America. He saw the change that needed to be done. And he was uplifted by that. He saw that. But what he also did, his legacy, was to show us the promised land. We've seen the promised land as well through his eyes. He let us see it, and by us seeing it, we know our responsibilities as well to make this a better country.
We have not yet won this fight on poverty that Martin Luther King made his mission in his final days. We still have work to do, but as he talked about being a drum major in the fight for justice, it is pretty heartwarming on a cold morning to see this many people lined up to make good on the promise that he committed to his people and his nation almost a half century ago.
Stand and lift our hands, for the joy of the Lord is our strength. We bow down and worship him now. How great, how awesome is he.
One of his famous quotes was, "People fail to get along because they fear each other. They fear each other because they don't know each other. They don't know each other because they have not communicated with each other." I agree with him.
What I have learned about Martin Luther King Jr., he was a very peaceful and spiritual man. He believed that all people should be treated the same, with great respect and compassion.
Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. once stated, "People fail to get along with each other because they fear each other. They fear each other because they don't know each other. They don't know each other because they have not communicated with each other." This statement indicates that people's inability to effectively communicate is in fact the root of misunderstanding and conflict between dissimilar groups.
This weekend we are celebrating the life of a great American and the person of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. He is a great man in history who believed that every person and every human being had the right to experience the freedom that we could live together as brothers and sisters. It was his belief and conviction that everybody should have the opportunity to the American dream, despite their race, color, or their creed. And in fact, on the day that Barack Obama was elected the president of the United States, my reflection kind of went back to Dr. King, because I believe that Dr. King, along with some of the other saints of heaven, looked over the balcony and said that America finally got it right. And I'm not saying that to say that they got it right because they elected Obama. I'm saying that they got it right that they were able to look beyond race, color, or creed and elect the best person at that time, we believe, for the job. The life of Dr. King and Obama has sent a strong message to our young people that any goal we set in life is attainable with hard work and perseverance, that you can't use the color of your skin as a reason to be sorry today, that you cannot no longer use the race card because we have too many opportunities that are available to us because of the hard work of Dr. King, as well as others who have made it possible for us to study in any university and be anything that we will want to be. Am I saying that people will still not judge you by the color of your skin? Absolutely, they will. Some Americans and some people still can't get beyond that. Will they still put stumbling blocks in your way? They sure will. But you can know today that there are some keys to success that will allow you to be the person that God has created you to be. Many feel when Dr. King was cut down by an assassin's bullet that he left many things undone. But I would simply say to you that he had finished his course, that he brought us where he needed to take it, and staying on course is not letting anything or anybody stop you from being what God has called you to be. Certainly longevity has its place. We all would like to live a long time, but I think that our goal and purpose is to do and be what Dr. King says. All I want to do is just please God, to have God be pleased with my life. So in spite of being thrown in jail, in spite of being accused, in spite of being deserted by friends, in spite of being attacked by foes, he had a journey and a course that was charted out by God. Death threats could not sidetrack him because he understood that by staying on course, that life was not only made for black Americans better, but life was made better for all Americans. There are so many things today that are trying to knock us off course. There is apathy, there is sympathy everywhere. When we try to do right, evil is always present. We're blown off course by disappointments. We're blown off course by hurts and despairs. We're blown off course by arrogance and self-righteousness. We have started strong, and we must be careful that we do not finish wrong. So I would say to you that I don't know when and I don't know where, but somehow I believe what Dr. King believed, that every valley shall be exalted and every hill and mountain shall be made low. The rough places will be made plain and the crooked places will be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed and all flesh shall see it together. I'm trusting God on this journey. I'm trusting God with my life. I'm trusting God with my abilities, and I'm going to run on and see what the end is going to be.